Guys, I'm giving you an update and I'm going to play it a little bit later in the video, but first I wanted to share with you guys some pictures of what I look like before. I know I do on my YouTube, I have some like before and after pictures and stuff, and gosh, you just don't know how much, like, looking back at it, I'm like, oh my god, I can't believe I posted that. But then I look at the things that I said, and the pictures that I posted, and I'm motivated by them. They inspire me, and I usually cry on every one of them. But and you know, and when I watch other people's videos, it's the same exact thing. I'm so inspired by everybody, even if it's a struggle. You know, I don't want to post all my victories and all the good things, and you guys not see the struggle, because I did make a post on my Facebook recently how I have been struggling lately with self-hate, and not completely out self-hate, but you know, we all have that little bit in us where we really give ourselves a hard time over any kind of weight issues we're having, and especially people who's dealt with it for a long period of time, like I have, who has been having ups and downs and sideways and turns around. But you know, it's not the end of it, and we can pick ourselves up and get back at it. And but you guys will see, you know, in the next, you know, in this video that I done, how I'm doing and stuff. And I probably left out some information, but this is not the end of me. I know it's been a while since I've posted, but I definitely want to get back at it. I've been struggling lately with self-esteem issues, which we all go through. But I think that, you know, sometimes when we dig deep enough, and you know, the big key to it is just getting back at it again and getting up and doing it, no matter what, no matter how much we hate to do it, and you know, no matter how much self-pity you want to give ourselves, and excuses we like to make, just get out there and start doing it again, and it'll come back to you, and you'll be a beast again. We'll be in beast mode again. But I did want to say real quick before you'll see in the next video, I had big struggles during the winter, and the spring and summer's my time of the year. The reason I struggle so much, well, first of all, is having personal issues in my life. And that's something that can really set you off in weight loss journeys. And I also have asthma. So it was really hard for me to get outside and walk and do stuff like I like to do. I'm an outside person. I'd rather be out mowing the yard or hiking or doing stuff like that. And I can't because I have asthma, and it really, like, kills my lungs. But there's still no excuse. I did do aerobics during the winter, and I still felt like it wasn't enough. But I am currently 230, and I've gained 15 pounds. Yes, I did beat myself up about it, and that's what I'm coming back from right now. And it's hard, but I'm going to do it, and I'm doing it now, and hoping to inspire somebody out there. If not, you know what, these videos are for myself, if anything. So yeah, this is me right now, and I'm gonna be posting some pictures of some of my befores. Like, you know, I've been on my weight loss journey for, oh my gosh, like ever. It feels like, no, probably, my son will be 9 in January, so I'm going on 9 years, and I'll try to find some pictures that I've never posted before, maybe some videos. Ooh, gosh, my face is like so fat. But again, you know, if you guys can blog, a video blog, or you don't have to post to YouTube, but at least just post it for yourself, like keep it and then go back and look at it. I'm telling you, it really changes you. It really does. But anyway, here's some pictures I was talking about in my little update for you guys. So much love and plenty of weight loss, guys. Here's some videos and pictures of me from 2007 up to the present time, 2015. You guys enjoy and know that our struggles are not easy and they're up and down, but eventually we'll get it right. And learn self-love, because that's a big part of it, loving who we are. Yeah.
inside the lines.
Okay, fine, take
over. I'm perfectly incomplete. I'm still working on my masterpiece.
And now
I'm gonna hang with the greats. Way to go, but it's worth the wait. No, you haven't seen the best of me. I'm still working on my masterpiece. And now
hi guys, this is Holly. I wanted to give you guys an update. I know it's been a while. I've been doing a juicing fast, more like a reboot, because I've kind of slipped over the winter, like during winter and everything here in Virginia. It was really hard for me. Part of weight loss is learning how to deal with situations, not just personal situations, but like weather situations. I've told you guys before in my videos that I have a hard time in the winter because it's hard for me to get out of the house and do stuff. I have asthma, so as soon as I get out and try to walk or stuff, I mean, it just like kills my lungs. So the motivation kind of slips, and I kept aerobics up, but I still felt like it was never enough. And I guess that's the thing about what we do. We feel like we're never doing enough or never good enough, or, you know, trying to keep it all together. I'll give you an update real quick. I gained about 15 pounds over the winter, and I've kind of like stayed at that weight. I think I was like 215 when I had stopped the videos. I had been 209 at my lowest, and that's the lowest I've been in like since I was in high school. And I got up to 215. I had started more working more towards fitness instead of I was still watching what I was eating, but it wasn't so much about the weight loss as much as it was for the fitness part and toning my arms and all that stuff. But so yeah, I did gain weight, and to be honest with you, I was ashamed and really hard on myself, and I'm still hard on myself. But I think it's just part of anybody that's been through major weight loss, or like, I think I've lost, I was 300 pounds. So, I mean, it's just that mindset you get. You're always hard on yourself. And, you know, I don't think there's anything wrong with that to a certain point. Now, if you get to where you're really beating yourself up about it and not eating because of it, or, you know, being unhealthy about it, you maybe should see somebody or talk to someone about that. But, you know, it's really... it's really hard. Everybody knows, and you know, I'm not really ashamed of it. I'm not, because it's part of the process. It's ups and downs of weight loss. And you know, I've had people say that juicing is really quick weight loss and it's really bad for you. I get that, and I've never went 30 days. I attempted 30 days. I got 15 days in and I got the stomach burst, so I had to stop. So I find myself doing like 2 or 3 day juicing fast and end up getting off of it and eating. And, you know, there's nothing wrong with that. I do got to tell you guys something very cool that happened last night. And I'll get to that in just a second. But changing your eating habits. And I'm totally for, you know, eating more veggies and fruits and going to more organic meats. I don't do beef. Every once in a while, I will do beef. I've got 3 kids, so and a husband who does not diet, and you know, he tries, but he's just not to that point. And you know, we all get to a point in our life where we feel like we need a change, and you know, I can't force anybody into that. And that goes for my kids too, and that's what I'm about to tell you guys about what happened last night. You know, it's hard living in a house full of kids, and you don't want to deprive your kids, but you want to, you know, set a good example for them. And when I first started my juicing fast, or even when I was 8 years ago when I started on my weight loss journey, I worried about my kids too. because being a parent, that's what you do. And, you know, I definitely wanted to set a good example. And finally, last night, kind of all was like, yes, you know, I'm doing things right. My kids still might get their nuggets at McDonald's, or which, you know, it's hard not to. It's really hard not to, especially coming from a low-income family. Anyway, my oldest son, Noah, he's 12, he came to me last night, and this has been happening over a year now, and he'll come to me every once in a while and say, Mommy, I think I want to go vegetarian, and I totally support that. But last night, he said, Mom, I'm going to stop pop again. I don't buy pop. They get it at their nana's, or, you know, when we go out for treats or whatever, they get it there. But he came to me last night and said, Mom, I'm going to stop pop, and I want to try to go vegan. And I was like, well, that's awesome. But it really was like really awesome, because at that point I was like, yes, I'm doing things right, you know. But I'm losing time on my phone, and I wanted to give you guys a quick update, and I'm going to continue to, and I hope you guys are doing awesome. Much love and plenty of weight loss.